Welcome to the FixSleep Bedtime Stories Channel, your sanctuary for relaxation, meditation, and a peaceful sleep. Immerse yourself in the soothing embrace of sleep-inducing tales, carefully crafted to transport you to mysterious lands. Let the gentle rain and serene sounds of nature accompany you on this journey to relaxation. Say goodbye to restless nights and welcome the embrace of a restful sleep with our magical sleep stories. So, let the tale begin. Neptune and the Sirens. Chapter 1. The Vanishing Song. In the boundless dominion of the ocean, where the waters shimmered with a myriad of colors concealed from the land above, a sense of foreboding began to stir. The sirens, revered throughout the sea realms for their enchanting songs and safeguarding of ancient secrets, were vanishing without a trace. These mysterious disappearances sent ripples of unease across the marine world, from the sunlit surface to the shadowy depths. Neptune, the venerable and mighty ruler of the seas, felt the disturbance from his throne in the grand underwater palace of Tritonus. Known for his immense power and wisdom, Neptune was adorned with a crown of coral and pearls, his trident forged from the deepest ocean minerals, glowing with an ethereal blue light that mirrored the ocean's heart. Concerned for the safety of his realm and its inhabitants, he decided to personally investigate the unsettling phenomenon. Mounting his majestic chariot, drawn by a team of the fastest seahorses, whose scales glittered like liquid silver under the watery sunlight, Neptune set forth. His chariot cut through the waters with grace and speed, creating swirls of bubbles in its wake as it moved towards the Coral Labyrinths, the last known location of the missing sirens. The Coral Labyrinths were situated on the outskirts of Neptune's domain, bordering the mysterious and perilous territories of the uncharted deep. This ancient city was a natural marvel, constructed from vibrant pink and gold coral reefs that had grown and intertwined over millennia. Its beauty was unparalleled, with archways and towers that spiraled towards the surface, catching the light of the sun and casting kaleidoscopic patterns across the sandy ocean floor. As Neptune arrived, the usual bustling activity of the labyrinths seemed subdued. The colorful coral fish that normally darted between the corals were few, and the merfolk who inhabited the area appeared anxious and somber. Neptune approached the center of the labyrinths, where the elders of the coral city had gathered to discuss the dire situation. The elders, wise and venerable creatures adorned in seaweed robes, greeted Neptune with deep respect. They recounted how, one by one, the sirens had disappeared, always at dusk, when the light made the water's surface look like a sheet of gold. No sign of struggle, no farewell song. They simply vanished, leaving behind an eerie silence that even the currents seemed to mourn. Determined to find answers, Neptune summoned the currents to his aid, commanding them to reveal any traces or clues. The waters obeyed, swirling vigorously around the labyrinthine passages, uncovering hidden nooks and secluded grottos. Despite the thorough search, the only clue emerged from a young merboy who claimed to have seen a shadow, large and menacing, fleeting through the water just before the last siren's disappearance. With this slender lead, Neptune knew that his journey must take him deeper into the realms of the ocean, towards the enigmatic and feared abyssal plains. However, before departing, he visited the sacred conch temple, a place of ancient magic and wisdom within the labyrinths. Here, Neptune sought the guidance of the oracle, a mystical seashell that whispered secrets carried by the ocean currents from the farthest reaches of his kingdom. The oracle's voice was like the sound of waves, both gentle and powerful. It spoke of a darkness that had stirred in the depths, an ancient force long asleep, but now awoken. The force was searching, hungry for the magic that the sirens possessed, their songs that could sway the tides and stir the hearts of all sea creatures. With a heavy heart, but resolute spirit, Neptune left the coral labyrinths, the echo of the oracle's warnings mingling with the rush of his chariot. As he ventured towards the uncharted waters, the ocean seemed to sense the gravity of his quest, parting respectfully at the surge of his chariot. The deeper Neptune traveled, the darker the waters became, and the vibrant life of the shallower seas gave way to the eerie calm of the abyss. In the depths of his oceanic realm, Neptune prepared to face whatever lay ahead. Armed with the knowledge of the oracle and the power of his ancient trident, he was determined to uncover the fate of the missing sirens, restore peace to his troubled waters, and confront the ancient darkness that threatened the harmony of his underwater world. As the light from his trident pierced the darkness, Neptune moved ever forward into the heart of the mystery that awaited him in the shadowy depths. Chapter 2, The Abyssal Council. Descending from the vibrant, sun-kissed shallows into the enigmatic abyssal plains, Neptune's journey took on a darker turn. Here, in the deepest reaches of his dominion, light from the surface was a mere memory, replaced by the ghostly glow of bioluminescent creatures and the dim, eerie shimmer from Neptune's own trident. This part of the ocean was seldom visited by the Sea King, reserved for times of great peril or need. The abyssal plains were a vast, desolate landscape, a bottomless canvas of dark sands and towering underwater mountains that seemed to stretch endlessly. Amidst this shadowy expanse stood the council hall, a structure formed from volcanic rock and adorned with luminescent corals that served as a beacon in the perpetual twilight. It was here that the Abyssal Council, comprising the oldest and wisest denizens of the deep, convened. As Neptune approached, the hall's grand gates, crafted from the salvaged remains of sunken ships and whalebones, slowly creaked open. Inside, the council awaited. Ancient sea turtles with shells encrusted in minerals. Wise octopi whose arms twitched with the currents of thought. And blind sharks that had seen centuries pass in darkness. Each member of the council had lived for eons, their minds repositories of the ocean's oldest secrets. Neptune entered the chamber with a sense of solemnity, his trident casting a blue glow that flickered off the walls, casting dancing shadows. The council members bowed their heads in respect. Then, one by one, they shared their knowledge of the disturbances in the deep. The first to speak was Ultramary, a turtle so old his shell was layered with the ocean's lore. "Great Neptune," Ultramare began, his voice a slow, rumbling echo. "The disappearance of the sirens has stirred the abyss. Their songs have long been the thread, weaving peace into the fabric of our realms. Now, silence reigns, and in its place, a darkness grows, nurtured by the absence of their melody." Following him, a blind shark named Sith swam forward, her movements slow, but filled with purpose. "I have sensed a shift in the currents," she explained. "An ancient force, once dormant beneath the Mariana Chasm, stirs awake. We believe it feeds on the magic that the sirens harbored. A magic ancient as the seas themselves." Neptune listened intently, piecing together the fragments of information. The council spoke of a creeping shadow, not merely a physical darkness, but an ancient entity, bound to the ocean's depths since the world's inception. It had been contained, sealed away by the very songs of the sirens, their harmonies acting as chains that held the darkness at bay. "The balance of our world is tilting," intoned an octopus named Vortex, his tentacles swirling in agitation. "Without the siren songs, the seal weakens, and the entity seeks to break free. Should it succeed, it would mean ruin not only for the deep, but for all waters under your reign." The council proposed a plan, a venture into the heart of the darkness to reaffirm the ancient seals, a task only Neptune, with his divine power, could hope to accomplish. They offered him artifacts of old, relics imbued with the raw forces of the ocean, a helm forged from the abyssal crystals, granting sight where light failed, a net woven from the hair of mermaids, strong enough to entangle the intangible, and a conch that could replicate the siren's call, perhaps strong enough to soothe the restless entity. Equipped with these ancient treasures, Neptune felt the weight of his duty heavier than ever. He thanked the council for their wisdom and their gifts, promising to restore balance and harmony. As he prepared to leave, Ultramare imparted one last piece of ancient lore. "Remember, mighty Neptune, darkness is not merely an absence of light, but a canvas for the light to return," the old turtle said, his eyes glinting with a spark of ancient wisdom. With a nod of understanding, Neptune turned his chariot toward the Mariana Chasm. The council's words echoed in his mind, a litany against the pressing silence of the deep. As he left the council hall, the gates closing silently behind him, the Sea King was not just a ruler, but a warrior set on a quest that could decide the fate of his entire kingdom. The abyss awaited, and with it, a confrontation with an ancient darkness that had awakened in the absence of song. Chapter 3, The Hidden City. Neptune's journey into the depths took him beyond the Abyssal Council's realm, deeper into the ocean than he had ever ventured. Here, the darkness was so profound that even the light of his trident seemed to struggle against the swallowing void. The Mariana Chasm loomed before him, a crevice so deep and ancient that it was said to be a scar left by the very creation of the earth, a portal to realms forgotten and tales untold. As he descended, the pressure built around him, a tangible force that sought to crush anything daring enough to intrude into these forsaken depths. But Neptune, protected by the helm of abyssal crystals, moved undeterred through the increasingly hostile environment. His eyes, enhanced by the helm, could see the shifting shapes of the ocean floor, revealing landscapes that no surface dweller could imagine. The entrance to the hidden city of Atlantia was guarded by giant stone statues of mer-warriors, their tridents raised in eternal vigilance. The city itself was carved directly into the side of the chasm, its buildings hewn from the black basalt that lined the abyss. Bioluminescent algae coated the structures, casting an otherworldly glow that illuminated the city in hues of green and blue. Atlantia was a remnant of a bygone era, built by a civilization of merfolk so ancient that their existence had faded into legend. Neptune approached the city gates, marveling at the intricacy of the carvings that depicted the history of Atlantia. Battles fought against sea monsters, the harnessing of underwater volcanoes for energy, and the creation of the siren songs that had once bound the darkness. As he entered the city, the silence was overwhelming. No current stirred, no fish swam. It was as if the city itself was holding its breath. The streets of Atlantia were lined with coral and pearl, but the beauty of the city was overshadowed by a palpable sense of dread. Neptune could feel the darkness pulsating from the heart of Atlantia, a darkness that the city's ancient builders had sought to contain with their advanced technology and powerful magic. Neptune's first destination within the city was the Grand Library, a repository of Atlantean knowledge preserved in scrolls made from seaweed fiber and ink derived from squid. The library was a vast cavern filled with rows upon rows of these ancient texts. Here, Neptune hoped to find clues about the nature of the darkness and how it might be subdued. He discovered texts describing the entity as a primordial force of chaos, one that had been sealed by the power of the siren songs integrated into the city's architecture. With this knowledge, Neptune proceeded to the city's central palace, where the sirens had once sung to maintain the seals. The palace was a magnificent structure with towering spires that seemed to pierce the very bedrock of the chasm. Inside, he found the remnants of a great hall, with a ceiling depicting the cosmos as known to the Atlanteans, each star a gem reflecting the light of his trident. It was here, in the depths of the palace, that Neptune found the sirens. They were imprisoned within a crystal dome, their forms faint and ethereal, as if they were barely clinging to existence. Their voices, once strong enough to hold back the darkness, were now silent, captured by the orb of silence, a spherical cage of dark energy that floated ominously in the center of the hall. Guarding the orb was the Leviathan, a creature of legend said to have been born from the darkness itself. The beast was a terrifying sight. Scales as hard as diamonds, eyes like black holes absorbing all light, and a maw capable of swallowing ships whole. Neptune, wielding his trident and net of mermaid hair, prepared for battle. The confrontation was titanic. The Leviathan moved with surprising speed for its size, its tail smashing against the palace walls, causing shards of rock to fall like rain. Neptune dodged and weaved, using the agility granted by his helm. He entangled the Leviathan with the net, pulling it close enough to strike at its heart with his trident. The battle raged, echoing through the abandoned city, a fight not just for the sirens, but for the balance of the entire ocean. Finally, with a mighty thrust, Neptune pierced the heart of the Leviathan, the creature letting out a final thunderous roar before collapsing into the darkness from which it had come. With the guardian defeated, Neptune approached the orb of silence. Using the power of his trident, he shattered the orb, releasing the sirens from their imprisonment. As the orb broke, a wave of sound burst forth, the sirens' voices once again filling the waters. Their song was weak but pure, a melody that began to weave through the city, restoring light and life to Atlantia. The darkness receded, forced back by the power of the sirens' renewed song. Chapter 4, Restoration and Revelation. With the orb of silence shattered and the sirens' voices liberated, their ethereal songs began to resonate through the waters, weaving a powerful spell that restored vibrancy to the once dimmed city of Atlantia. Neptune watched as color returned to the bioluminescent algae on the buildings, and life began to stir in the shadows. The sirens, now free from their crystalline prison, floated gracefully around him, their forms becoming more solid, and their faces expressing profound relief and gratitude. As the darkness receded, pushed back by the power of the sirens' rejuvenated songs, Neptune felt a deep sense of peace. Yet, he knew that the battle was not merely against a physical foe, but against an ancient imbalance that had threatened his realm. The revival of Atlantia and the liberation of the sirens marked a new beginning, but also a time for understanding and vigilance. In the aftermath of the battle, the eldest siren, Seraphine, approached Neptune. Her voice was melodic and carried the weight of many centuries. "Great Neptune, you have saved us from an endless silence. But know this, the darkness you have pushed back is as old as the sea itself, born from the very depths of creation," she explained. Her eyes, reflecting the deep blue of the ocean, held wisdom and a hint of sadness. Seraphine led Neptune through the revived city, showing him the ancient mechanisms and magical artifacts that the Atlanteans had once used to balance the darkness. "Our songs were part of a greater harmony, a balance between light and dark. When the orb silenced us, that balance was disrupted," she continued. As they walked, they passed murals depicting the history of Atlantia and its connection to the wider ocean, revealing how the city had once been a hub of magical and technological advancements, now lost to the world above. Neptune listened intently, absorbing every detail. The siren's tales wove together pieces of his own knowledge, pieces of a puzzle he had never seen complete. Seraphine spoke of the celestial alignment, an event occurring once every millennium when the stars align in such a way that their energy could either renew the world or plunge it into chaos. The next alignment was approaching, and without the siren's songs to maintain the balance, the darkness would grow strong again. As they reached the center of Atlantia, where a great crystal spire rose towards the dark waters above, Seraphine gestured to the intricate carvings on its base. They depicted the celestial alignment and the role of the sirens in channeling the celestial energies into the sea, using the spire as a conduit. "This spire, with our songs, harnesses the starlight, feeding it into the heart of the ocean, keeping the darkness at bay," she explained. Neptune realized the magnitude of what was required of him. He must ensure the protection of this system, not just for the safety of his realm, but for the balance of the entire world. The thought was daunting, yet a resolute determination filled him. He would not allow the darkness to return. He would protect this ancient harmony at all costs. Determined to fortify Atlantia's defenses and ensure no future threats could endanger the siren songs, Neptune called upon his subjects from all corners of the ocean. Merfolk engineers, wizards, and warriors heeded his call, arriving in Atlantia to lend their skills and magic. Together, they began to repair and enhance the city's ancient technology, integrating it with modern magic and knowledge. As the days passed, Atlantia transformed from a city of shadows into a beacon of hope and knowledge. Libraries were restored, workshops buzzed with activity, and the crystal spire shone brighter than ever, its light a pillar in the watery darkness. Neptune oversaw the progress, ensuring that every improvement was in harmony with the old ways. The day of the celestial alignment finally arrived. Neptune, the Sirens, and all of Atlantia's inhabitants gathered around the crystal spire. The Sirens began to sing, their voices clearer and more beautiful than ever, infused with the power of the aligned stars. The spire absorbed the celestial energy, glowing with a brilliant intensity, and then released it in a pulse of light that rippled throughout the entire ocean. As the light spread, it carried with it a sense of renewal and balance. Far above, sailors on the surface world noticed the ocean seemed calmer, the waves gentler, and the air fresher. Below, in the depths, the balance was restored, and the darkness retreated into the furthest corners of the abyss, its power waning under the renewed harmony. Neptune stood at the heart of Atlantia, watching as peace settled over his realm. Seraphine joined him, her eyes gleaming with unshed tears of joy. "Thank you, Neptune, for believing in our songs," she said softly. "You have taught me much, Seraphine," Neptune replied, his voice filled with gratitude. "The songs of the Sirens will forever be the heart of our world, ensuring that darkness and light remain in balance." As the celebrations began, Neptune felt a deep contentment. Atlantia was alive, its knowledge and magic a gift to the ocean once more. He knew challenges would come, as they always do. But with the Sirens' songs resonating through the seas, peace would reign. For the harmony of the deep was restored, and it would be defended for generations to come.